Right where you are, it's time to check out all the action on that hot new show, How I Spent My Summer Vacation. Watch the ABC stars grab some fun in the sun with special guest star Craig T. Nelson, who spent his summer learning to race motorcycles. And special guest stars from Full House, Mary-Kate and Ashley Olsen, who had a rocking good time. Plus the stars of the new season, like Brett Butler, who took some shots at the rich and famous. The dynamic duo from Moon Over Miami, Bill Campbell and Allie Walker. They made some big waves this summer. And the new heavyweight champion of situation comedy, George Foreman. He'll knock you out. Returning in a brand new series, Judith Light. She lights up any room. From Joe's life, Peter Onorati. Solid as a rock. ABC's newest young star, Ben Savage. He's surrounded by stars. And joining the festivities is that outrageous new funny lady, Thea Vidal. She's cooking up some big laughs. With your host, Joan London.
This is Catalina Island, only an hour's boat ride away from the ABC studios in Hollywood. Hello, I'm Joan London, and I am spending part of my summer vacation right here in this picture-perfect setting. And what better place to take a look at how some of the stars of ABC have been spending their summer vacations? We'll see everything from Craig T. Nelson racing motorcycles to George Foreman racing to the fast food counter. And we'll also see stars as they jet ski and parasail and even cook up some ribs at a down-home barbecue. And along the way, we will see highlights from some of the new ABC fall shows. So let's get started. There were no busier seven-year-olds than Mary-Kate and Ashley Olsen, America's favorite twins who play Michelle on Full House. How's this for a busy summer? Filming another ABC movie of the week, a TV Guide cover story, a soon-to-be-released record album and music video, and the formation of their own production company. I think most of us at seven were still mastering the fine points of Mr. Potato Head, I don't know. But with all that going on, the girls still had time to let loose with their friends, like every other kid in America. And like every other kid in America, they knew they'd have to write a report on what they did over their summer vacation.
Our Summer Vacation by Mary-Kate and Ashley Olsen. There's so much to write about. Our extracurricular activities, our new video. I'll start with the video. It's the only one I can spell.
Mary-Kate and Ashley Olsen, our first video, take one.
Someday, I'd like to be president. It's a job that's caught my eye. I know I'd enjoy being president. And here's the reason why. No one tells the president how to dress. No one bugs him if his Oval Office is a mess. When it's time to mow the White House lawn, if anybody tried to teach him that they'd be resigned. No one tells the president not to slouch. No one says, don't put your feet on Mr. Lincoln's couch. No one tells him, company's here, use your fork and spoon. Unless they want to be the next ambassador to the moon.
Went to Vancouver, where we borrowed a camera and shot some great scenes. Eat your heart out, Steven Spielberg. There's something funny about those Canadian buildings. They just don't stand still.
Lucky for us, Ashley is a wizard with a camera.
How do you work this thing?
Taking pictures is a piece of cake, upside down cake. My sister and I took turns taking shots of each other. Of course, I didn't have much to work with.
Mary-Kate, you're not getting a close-up of me.
That's what you think. We always drink milk for lunch. This time we shared it with a friend. A dear friend. Sorry.
While we were in Canada, we shot our new TV movie, Double Double Toil and Trouble. On the way to the set, we thought we would loosen up the crew by singing this catchy tune.
I know a song that gets on everybody's nerves. Everybody's nerves. Everybody's nerves. I know a song that gets on everybody's nerves.
We're talking to the actor who plays the gravedigger in the movie. I wouldn't like to have that job. The movie's going to be on TV on October 30th. And here's one of our favorite parts. He won't hurt you.
Who said that?
Me.
Oh, hi.
Yeah, that's just Norman. He wouldn't hurt anybody.
But you were over there?
No, that was me.
Ah, you're in two places at the same time.
We're twins, silly.
Twins.
Do you drink a lot of coffee? You might want to switch to decaf.
Oh, I have to hurry. I'm going home as soon as I can, and I'm not leaving my house again until the day after Halloween.
How come?
Don't you know what happens on Halloween?
Yeah, you go trick-or-treating. This guy needs to get out more.
Ah, home at last. Now for some peace and quiet. Right, Mary Kate, but now we can finally get some rest.
This picnic is being hosted by one of TV's sassiest personalities, comedian Thea Vidal. In her new series, Thea raises her four kids in a no-nonsense style. And the only thing spicier than her special barbecue sauce is her special brand of humor.
Hi, I'm Thea Vidal. And what I did for my summer vacation, I decided to have a bunch of my friends over, people I like, kind of, sort of, you know. I like them a lot, but they owe me money, so I figure if I got everybody here, I can get that cash in one fell swoop. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, I'm going to make some of my secret barbecue sauce, and you're going to watch me cook, and you can get to know some of my friends. So just hang out with me. This is Gail. Now, Gail is one of the executives on my show, Thea on ABC, which I know most of you will be watching because I know where some of you live. And remember, Ma, if you don't watch this show, I'll never make enough money to pay you back, okay? Think about that. But anyway, this is Gail. Smile, Gail, smile. And she has a brain in her head and everything, but it's got full of air. But don't worry about that. This is my ex-husband, low life. But anyhow, but see, I get along with everybody. And look, and it's a precious baby. Just look, he's so cute. He's never seen a black person before, but he's okay. Anyhow, this is Carol. Smile, Carol. Smile, Carol. The camera's that way, darling. Smile. She's a very intelligent woman, a very successful corporate lawyer, and she's not married, and she's 43, and her clock is really ticking. I told you not to eat, didn't I? Now, I don't want to hear all of that. I ain't inviting you no more. I don't care if you are married to my sister. Him. Anyhow, somebody brought their dog. I don't know. It looked like a rat with hair.
And I know some of y'all are thinking, you know, how could a big girl like me just have all these friends and have, you know, this big party, all this food, when I should be trying to cut down and be healthy? And some people out there right now are thinking about, if in every big woman, there's a thin one trying to get out. Well, all I have to say to that is I ate her. I deep fried her like some chicken and gobbled her butt up. Hey, now if you a fool enough to put your hand on that fire, that's your happy behind. But if you get burnt, don't be talking about you want to sue something. Get your hand off of stuff. You know, you can go home. That, now see, you put that mop on. You see, you can see the seasonings in the mop. Isn't that something? Because I know what I'm doing. You can't be black and not barbecue. You know, the only bad thing about having a barbecue is that the bugs get on your nerves.
In her new series, Thea plays a widowed mother who guides her children through their important growing up years.
Okay, gotcha.
What's up, Mama?
I'm up. I'm always up when I see my precious baby.
This is Sydney.
I can't tell you how it warms my heart to see my sons sticking together, especially to defy their mother.
Defy? No, Mama.
No, wait a minute. Now, we're not defying you.
Never defy.
What would you call it?
Something that doesn't sound so bad.
I got it. Naughty. Wouldn't you agree, Jarvis? We were being naughty. That says quite
a bit. This is Lena Thurman. This is my mother.
Hi, how are you?
Hello, Leonard.
I'll expect you home around 9:12. Oh, I'm just teasing. Make it 9:15. Live a little.
Goodbye, Leonard.
Check out the sneak preview of Thea tonight at 9:30, 8:30 Central. In our next segment, one of our youngest ABC stars realizes the dream of a lifetime. Stay tuned. If the name Ben Savage sounds familiar to you, it's probably because this young man is following in the footsteps of his older brother, Fred, who starred in the hit show, The Wonder Years. Now, while Fred's show took place in the sentimental 60s, Ben's new show, Boy Meets World, is set in the nervous 90s. And in the series, Ben plays an 11-year-old who's very inquisitive, searching for answers about growing up while coping with the pressures of adolescence.
I want to make an announcement about this year's regional geography tournament. As some of you may know, for the past 5 years, I have always fielded a champion, and I expect to do the same this year. So, based on his outstanding scholastic achievement, I have selected as this year's entrant...
Minkus. Have you selected Minkus?
Mr. Minkus.
Why do you get detention?
Apparently, he'd rather listen to a baseball game on the radio than try to understand the emotional content of Romeo and Juliet.
Mom, I'm a kid. I don't understand the emotional content of Full House.
I do.
Don't kill my first concert, okay?
This isn't your first Aerosmith concert.
Madison Square Garden, 1978.
We were there. You were here.
You ate him?
Aren't you going to invite me to have tea with you?
Ben's favorite activity is tennis. This summer, Ben got to meet several of his idols when he was selected to be an honorary ball boy at a charity tennis match.
Ladies and gentlemen, one of the all-time greats, Chris Everett.
From Melrose Place, please welcome Andrew Hsu. Over the net, yeah! Please welcome one of the evening's tennis players, Dustin Hoffman. We're not in Japan, Dustin. Come on. This is America. Tennis Magazine quoted, "He merges a dynamic personality with an energized playing style. He won Wimbledon last year, the biggest tournament in the world, 1992. Please welcome Andre Agassi.
I was a little nervous because I didn't know how to get the ball, so I kept on asking the line judge where I could get them, and he said they'll come to you.
Hey, umpire, would you get this match under control, please?
Dustin Hoffman, I think, is a wonderful actor. I've seen many of his movies, and I just thought it was really cool to be able to give him a ball. It was a thrill to actually throw a ball to Andre Agassi because he's a legend.
Just the big one once, just once.
The ball when Agassi served it, the speed was like, phew, very fast.
Well, we finally saw the big one.
When I found out I could be a ball boy for these four players, I was very excited and I was just so happy. It was a great experience, and I just had a very fun day.
A special thanks to our celebrity ball boy, Ben Savage.
Boy Meets World premieres Friday, September 24th at 8:30, 7:30 Central.
You don't have to be a boxing fan to know the name George Foreman. He is going to be trading punches for punch lines this season when he stars in the new ABC comedy, George. In this series, former heavyweight champ George Foreman will play George Foster, a former heavyweight champ. And George Foster is going to run an after-school youth program in Houston, much like the one George Foreman runs in real life. It does tempt one to say that art is imitating life here, but then again, George Foreman is really larger than life.
And how did George spend his summer vacation? Trying to feed that larger-than-life appetite.
Hey, driver, what is the farmer's market?
It's a pretty incredible spot, George. I hear they got about 70 places to eat.
People know me for training on cheeseburgers, hot dogs, pizzas. Anyhow, I think it's time to expand my horizons and try some new experiences in fine dining.
Can I help you, sir?
I'd like some sushi, please. Well done.
Well done. ちょっと待ちください、sir. はい、どうぞ。お寿司ですよ。 そうそうそうそうそう。それで食べるんです。はい。そうそうそうそうそう。ダメですね。
This must be the diet plate.
You want a spaghetti? How is that, George?
Oh, thank you, Rose.
Wait a minute. The sauce. We mustn't forget the sauce. You can't eat spaghetti without the sauce. Okay, there you go.
Wow, that's what I want.
George, wait a minute. I forgot. You'll have to forgive me here. We have to have some good imported Romano cheese that really makes this taste absolutely marvelous. How is that? That's fine.
I love you, Fanny.
George, have you ever had any of my meatballs? There you go.
Oh, boy, here you go.
That's great. George, you can't eat it. It's cold. I've got to take this away. I'm sorry.
I wonder, is this how Tommy Lasorda got skinny?
George, this sure is good.
But you ought to try some real kosher deli food.
Yeah, maybe you got a point. What do you suggest?
We have kreplach soup.
Kreplach?
Kreplach.
Kreplach?
Kreplach. Lach. Lach.
Lach. Lach. I should get this fella some water.
And we have flanken.
Flanken? Don't call me no flunky on television.
It's flanken, not flunky. Flanken.
I feel like such a newtnik.
Always nice to experiment with some new food, but it's always fun to get back to old reliables.
George, you're killing yourself. All that cholesterol, high sodium, high fat. My doctor would never let me eat that.
I'd get a second opinion. Hey, listen, while I'm chowing down, here's some clips from my new television show. Watch that.
In this scene from George, George Foster confronts some of his problem students for the first time.
Afternoon, gentlemen.
You George Foster?
That's who I am.
What you doing here? Your limo breakdown?
You got a name, young man?
What's it to your mama?
What's it to your mama? African name, right? Ruth, I like it. Who do we have here?
Shasta Roberta Rose, if it's any of your business, which it ain't.
Shasta Roberta Rose.
Yeah, and I'm like the desert. I can't be crossed.
You know? Look, I know you, Pops. You're here because you need to feel better about being black and rich.
Hey, I don't feel guilty about being rich. You see, I'm rich because I can read.
Man, you rich because you big and you beat the crap out of people, man. That make you rich. I'm gonna be a billionaire.
I took some shots, but I ain't down yet.
Watch for George on Saturdays this fall on ABC. Coaches Craig T. Nelson spent his summer being coach on how to race a motorcycle. We'll be right back to show you the results.
We call it roomier by 5.4 cubic feet. Bob Sinclair calls it his troop transport. We call it a quieter ride thanks to liquid-filled engine mounting. Dave Billings calls it his decompression chamber. We call it a standard driver's side airbag and available anti-lock brakes. The Scots call it their security blanket. We call it Corolla, the all-new Toyota Corolla, the brand-new car with a familiar name.
In a world that's moving very fast, we can find balance in our days and in our diets with foods like Dannon yogurt that put back what the world takes out of us. Dannon yogurt, deliciously creamy, nutrient dense, which means in very few calories we get a lot of nutrition, calcium, potassium, real yogurt cultures, and the sense that there's a place in each day where we can find balance. Dannon yogurt, a very healthy habit for life.
Start a project with Minwax Wood Finish and turn new into treasured, ordinary into extraordinary, even pine into cherry, because Minwax Wood Finish makes it easy to turn any project into a beautiful masterpiece. Minwax makes wood beautiful.
Some days your hair needs more conditioning. Some days maybe less.
No matter what your hair goes through, Finesse condition just for you.
Finesse Adjusting Conditioner is activated by your hair's changing needs. Conditions more on days you need it, less on days you don't.
That's the beauty of Finesse. Conditions more, conditions less. That's the beauty of Finesse. Conditions more, conditions less. That's the beauty of Finesse.
And now for some thin, different.
New Domino's Thin Crust Pizza. A crispy, crunchy crust pizza. Now buy any thin crust pizza and get an order of Domino's Twisty Bread free.
Something for nothing when you call Domino's.
Next. Check home improvement, then meet Thea.
What's up, Mama?
I'm up. I'm always up when I see my precious babe.
Thea's the mom with more power.
From now on, think of this as your country. And you know your room up there? That's gonna be your capital.
Well, that means video games are out?
For you, a memory.
A special preview of Thea.
To the capital.
Right after Home Improvement, tonight.
Now, you probably know Bill Campbell from his starring role as the high-flying hero in the hit movie The Rocketeer. And Allie Walker has her own action credentials. She's co-starred with Jean-Claude Van Damme in The Universal Soldier. Now, Bill and Allie have teamed up in ABC's new romantic comedy series called Moon Over Miami. It is set in the trendy area of South Beach. Bill and Allie play these two people who meet under some strange circumstances, and they form an unconventional detective team. And as you'll see, it's a show where anything can happen.
Guinevere, don't you dare.
Excuse me, did you say overboard?
I want my daughter back. Whatever it takes, no matter how much it costs.
There's somebody in your bed.
We're in my bed.
Who is it? Sir. You get out, or I'll shoot you.
You will not.
Oh, yes, I will.
Your finger's not even on the trigger.
No.
I am feeling very conflicted.
Mr. Taylor has defrauded the Bank of Nice of $2.1 billion.
We need proof this side of the Atlantic. Something with Taylor's fingerprints on it.
Wire me.
You're kidding.
You have a better idea?
The secret to a successful undercover operation is as follows. Keep it simple, keep it subtle, keep it quiet. Any questions?
Sort of takes your breath away, don't it?
Now that you mention it, yeah.
South Beach. As any local will tell you, this is the in place for fun in the sun. And with all this as their playground, Bill and Allie just had to try some South Beach style recreation. So they took a day off from working together and spent it playing together.
So, Al?
So, Bill, here we are.
What do you think, Miami?
I just hope to God it's not hurricane season.
Well,
anyway, so Billy, so we're just moving here from fabulous Los Angeles. What do you think of this place?
I think the water's got to be better than Santa Monica Bay.
Yeah, well, that doesn't say much, does it? So, Bill, white sand coming up.
Hey, jet skis?
I'm burning jet skis.
Parasailing?
Near-death experience. Maybe you've heard of it. I don't want to die, but hell, what the hell? Whose idea was this for vacation anyway?
Okay, this is a Yamaha Wave Runner. It's a lot of great, this thing. Push the green button, it starts. Push the red button, it stops. The only way this thing will turn is if you're giving it gas. Okay, guys, the way I anticipate you're going to ride, you're probably going to fall off this machine. Grab the two sides, give a kick, and lift yourselves up.
Okay.
So that's it.
I think we've got it down. Thanks so much. That was great. I know I had a great time, and I think Bill did too, huh, Bill? Come on, Bill. Let's go. He'll be fine. He does this occasionally.
Okay, Bill Allie. My name's Ken. This is Ernesto. Come on, step over onto the tube and then into the boat, one at a time. Well, there you go. So you're going to do some serious pirate sailing today on the world's highest boat, hey? There you go.
Well, Bill, if you'll notice behind you there, there's quite a few gray clouds.
I think I see some lightning.
Death by lightning or eaten by a great white. I, of course, will be on the boat. Stick them down. Thank you.
Okay, Bill, Ernesto's going to be up here steering the parachute. What you're going to do is you're going to come up here, duck under the line, and clip your clips into these two triangles.
I see.
After you clip in, I want you to sit on your butt.
Stop.
Billy, be really careful.
Thanks, Ellie. Oh, shit. This is just spectacular. Just fantastic. And I am going to sue ABC for every cent. They have.
That.
All right.
that's enough fun for today. I want to go home. What are you doing? I seem to be approaching the boat. Look, I'm going to get chopped up in the propeller here. I'm headed toward the propeller. What's happening? Okay, what do I do? Stand up? Stand up.
Moon Over Miami premieres Wednesday, September 15th at 9:30, 8:30 Central.
I could have gone fishing. I could have played golf. But this is how I spent my summer vacation.
Although he looks like a member of Hell's Angels or a hippie from the 60s, that's Coach's Craig T. Nelson, and he spent his summer racing motorcycles for an upcoming ABC movie.
My name's Craig T. Nelson, and I have a hair weave, and I've grown a beard. We're doing a movie here, and I wrote it, and I'm starring in it, and I'm executive producer. The bike's speed is depends on the track, but if, say, Springfield, which is a mile track, they'll go 140 down a back straight, and then about 100 mile an hour into the turns. We were doing a drive out of the garage, and I was on the 66 bike, and we did it once, and we did it again, and the bike did a wheelie, and it just scared me to death. That last one was a good one.
The best one of the day.
Yeah. Man, that one is awesome. Shaver and my chemistry is very special because she's such a good actress, and when you're playing opposite someone like that, you realize that none of the pictures that are taken of you are any good.
As this scene demonstrates, even though Craig plays a tough, macho motorcycle rider, he also has a tender side.
Hi.
Hi.
Kate, I'd like to take you to dinner tonight.
Oh, Frank, thank you, but Danny expects me at the hospital every night.
I'll pick you up at the hospital. At 7:30? Danny's going to be resting by then, and come on, I promise to have you back at 9 o'clock sharp.
Thank you, but no.
What kind of food do you like?
What?
Food. What kind of food do you like? See, I need to know in order to make a reservation. I mean, fancy's okay, but not too fancy, all right?
Yeah.
Great. I'll see you at 7:30. Bye. You know, the fancy, I don't have a suit.
When we come back, we'll go on a whirlwind ride with one of TV's busiest stars, Judith Light. This season marks the return to series television of Judith Light, who stars in the comedy Phenom with William Devane. For Judith, the summer was just like her winter, spring, and fall. Hectic.
My summer vacation began by leaving Los Angeles and going to landing in Rome and going to the Italian Open. And the highlight of the whole trip, we went on a bike trip through the hills of Umbria. I probably shouldn't be taking my hands off the wheel like this because everybody's gonna think I'm a terrible driver. So I was biking like 30 and 40 miles a day. And then what you do is you're so exhausted, you change clothes really fast, and then you go out to like a 3 or 4 star restaurant for dinner.
Thank you, Judith.
Thank you. So sweet. And you're seeing some of the most incredible history, some of the most incredible art that you will ever see in your entire life. And it's like the best exercise in the world. And of course, you can eat anything you want because, you know, you're getting off the bike, you're going to have lunch, and you work it all off in the afternoon. It's also extremely good for the thighs. Just in case anybody ever asked you if that's the reason to go on a bike trip, it's very good for your thighs and your tushy. For the new show coming up, I get to play a mother who is divorced, who doesn't have a lot of money, who's got a child who's a prodigy, and she's got to try to combine her child's life and her child's talent and make that a workable situation for herself and try to have a life for herself and try to make a life for her other kids. In this scene, my daughter, a tennis phenom, deals with a demanding coach.
Can I be a great player and a normal person?
Of course not.
Say there's a tournament next weekend and my best friend's having a party. Which do I do?
If you were my pupil, I would say go to the tournament.
What if she were your daughter?
If she were my daughter, I would say go to the tournament, stupid.
My high school graduation.
The tournament.
The senior prom.
The tournament.
Her mother's funeral.
Tournament. Now listen, you're good, but you don't know what it means to compete, to truly compete, to believe so completely in yourself that there is no self, to know you are fearless, to know you are feared. This is a gift that I can give to you. Take me!
At any rate, I have a minute and a half before I start work on Phenom, and my friend Bill Gordine, who I absolutely adore and who I think is a brilliant antique dealer, I wanted to help him move into his store so that I could get to spend a little time with him and support him, and also so I could get first dibs on everything, which is really what I intend to do. Voila, we're here.
How are you?
God.
What do you think, huh?
Ooh, hi.
How are you?
Hi.
Good to see you, huh?
Good to see you, Matt.
What do you think?
I think it's fantastic.
Got a mess here. We've got a lot of work to do here. So, let's see what we can do.
If we don't like the way it looks, we'll just keep changing the room until we get it the way we want it. This is too high.
Yeah, it's too high. All you right. Can't see. Let's flank the clock.
Now, see, this is great. Ooh, that's so charming. Nice. Now, wait a minute. Sit down.
You know what?
Don't you love that? All right, I'm bringing this out.
Okay.
This is so exciting. I can't wait for the opening. Oh, Bill, this is fabulous. It's beautiful. I love what you've done.
It came out nice, huh?
It's just fabulous. Here's to Villa Melrose.
And here's to Phenom.
Phenom premieres Tuesday, September 14th at 8:30, 7:30 Central. Now, Grace Under Fire explores the world of single motherhood with honesty and humor. It centers around a Southern woman who is living in the Midwest, who's determined to make the best life possible for herself and her three children. The lead role is played by Georgia's own Brett Butler, who is known for her razor-sharp observations peppered with a little good old girl insight. And being a country gal at heart, she decided to spend a vacation day in the hills.
So this is where I spent my summer vacation, Beverly Hills. Why? Because my self-esteem was just a little too high, and I needed it chopped down into little bits. Yeah, I'm right here on Rodeo Drive. What? You're kidding. Rodeo Drive. But be careful in this town, because I got a ticket for driving without cheekbones. Beverly Hills, home of slender women, and lizard women, the ones who've had so much cosmetic surgery, they're not even biodegradable anymore. Their necks start to look like this. Darling, I'd love to laugh at your little jokes, but my stitches will fly everywhere. And by the way, I'm the first person in the history of this town to ever walk down these steps. The people who live here just hire someone to do it for them. Ta-da! My favorite store windows here are safari outfits. I love that. In Beverly Hills, when's the last time any one of these people was ever in the wild? They probably think in the wild is going all the way out to Pasadena. Oh, look, darling, the middle class. They're just roaming free, untethered. Well, we should shoot one and take it home. Do we still have that good gardener? Because maybe this one can be broken and trained. Can you just kill people here? Are you self-absorbed, but just a little chilly?
Have we got duds for you.
Of course, the silly thing is that it's never winter in Beverly Hills. And anybody who goes in there is just showing off, because you know they're going to be in Aspen or Destad or Lucerne over the winter. And
it's like,
as cold as it ever gets here, it's only 68 degrees. And you'd wear this? It's like, it was just positively freezing last night. It dipped almost 69 degrees. It was terrible. We didn't have any wood, so we threw another maid on the fire. Some places in America have such historical impact that it's really difficult to even talk about them. This is one of those places. I suppose it's on a level with the cracked Liberty Bell or even the arrival of the Pilgrims. This is a much more recent episode and a much more horrific one. This is the spot where Zsa Zsa Gabor slapped a policeman in Beverly Hills. God, I don't think any of us will ever forget those riots. They're embedded in our nation's mind. How the rich people from Beverly Hills came and threw Persian Ottomans through store windows and stole perfume samples from behind counters. And it's really hard to talk about, isn't it? Of course, we found out later the real reason she hit him is because he guessed how old she was. All right, at this point, I've reached the end of my love affair with Beverly Hills. Basically, I don't think I have the facial expressions necessary to abide in this town. To shop here and be a woman, a jeune fille, if you will, one must adopt an expression not unlike, I don't care how outrageously wonderful anything you see is, your face must always be one of disdain, aloofness, and sheer boredom. And of course, you know, the fact that I'm not exactly like the most petite thing here, of course, the motto in Beverly Hills is, just can't keep a good meal down. I tell you what, if I ever do come back to this town, you know what it's going to be like? It's going to be me in overalls with a big piece of hay sticking out front and one of my teeth blacked out, and I'm going to come say, boy, that sure is some pretty stuff. I'd like to buy me some of that. And they'll sell it to me because I'll be so damn rich they'll have to. So I was thinking about my vacation in Beverly Hills, how alluring it was and intoxicating, all the vanity and glamour. But where does it all end? I'll tell you where it ends. Right here at the La Brea Tar Pits, in that quagmire, centuries to come, every artificial thing ever injected, surgically implanted, or rubbed into the human body will float to the surface. Just ponder all the mammoth chest bubbling to the top, or all the little pointy noses that our children will hurt their feet walking on in years to come. It's awful. We're going to end up just like those mastodons over there. It'll be like the mineral bath that never, ever ends.
I'm melting!
Now let's watch some scenes from Grace Under Fire as Brett plays a single mom trying to build a life of her own.
Yeah, I did say I wanted to meet you and sometime, and Nadine's kind of pushy and she dragged
me. Oh, shut up and ask her out.
I just came out of a really bad marriage and I'd like to ask you a couple of questions first.
Have a seat. Got some questions of my own.
Do you chew tobacco or on a belt buckle bigger than my head?
No. Have you ever had the fat sucked out of your thighs and injected into your lips?
No, but thanks for the tip.
Okay, I think we can do this.
Yeah, this'll work. Russell, I'm sorry. Babysitter said she'd be here at 7 o'clock. I don't know where she is.
That's okay. I'm having a good time.
There's no way I'm leaving my babies with Sid and Nancy.
Mommy?
What, honey?
Can I tell you a secret?
Well, Libby, it's not polite to tell secrets in front of people. If you want to say something, you can say it in front of everybody.
That man has a fat butt.
Grace Under Fire this fall on ABC. When we return, we'll meet the Pavarotti of cement. In Joe's life, Peter Onorati is a restaurant chef by night and a Mr. Mom by day. Now, playing a house husband, Peter discovers that running a household is one of the toughest jobs around. Now, this summer, Peter's TV chores spilled into his real life when he found himself helping his acting pal, Randy Rudy, with the home improvement project. This project tested both their muscles and their friendship.
Hey! You want to bring something up with you when you come next time? Huh?
Yeah. I got another mother now. What a way to spend my summer vacation. I should have never let him do that electrical work in my house. Now I gotta work for him for the rest of my life. Be nice if I could work in a normal place, not on the side of Mount Everest. But no, I gotta find a friend who lives like a goat. It's a nice view.
Yeah, cement. We need a cement. Not sand, cement.
You said sand.
No, I said cement.
This is an excellent example of Italo-American craftsmanship.
Right.
The whole form conforms to the earth itself. There's an intermingling, like a song, like an opera. This wall was built 1992 AP, after Peter. Let me show you another wall. This wall was built about 1986 BP, before Peter.
You notice I'm mixing cement alone.
It seems incomplete. It lacks love. Whereas my wall says opera, art. This says gastrointestinal dysfunction.
His wall says opera. My wall says country western. Howdy.
Now we're ready for art. How am I supposed to work with this? What am I supposed to do with this? Huh?
That's perfect.
It is not perfect. Look, it doesn't stick to anything.
It's sticking to my shirt.
If this wall is an opera, then this trowel is the conductor's baton. So we lay a little cement up here, get a little platform for what we hope is going to be the perfect rock and the perfect addition to this opera.
That's it.
Place this in here. In order to make the bed more perfect, place your perfect rock, and everything just seems
I got
perfect.
It. Huh? Huh? Here it is.
No, I got it already.
No, I got it here.
It's perfect.
Yeah.
I've been
hold it.
Buttered.
Hold it. There you go. There. See what that's saying?
What's that say?
That says rustic.
Rustic. Rustic's over there. Okay, let's do perfect right here. See? Now, tell me. Are you like that?
I love that.
You love it?
Yeah, I love that.
Lunch.
Now here's another look at Peter as he plays a hassled dad in charge of the house in Joe's life.
Dad! Come on, do I have to explain to you why you can't have gum?
No.
How come you can't have gum?
Because he chews it for maybe 2 seconds and then he just leaves it anywhere. It drives Mom crazy.
Yo, Scotty.
What?
I'm gonna give you some gum. And when you get done, I wanna see you throw it away. Deal?
Deal.
What?
He wants gum, he gets gum. I wanna use the phone, I get to make a salad. How come, Dad? Because he's younger or because he's a boy?
You know, you're right. Gotta be one of the two.
How'd it go around here today?
Not bad. You know, I mean, the kids outnumber me and all, but if I can keep them hating each other, they'll never unite against me.
Listen, if the kids are giving you any trouble, I'll talk to them.
Don't worry about it. I got everything under control.
Joe's Life this fall on ABC. Okay, so the bad news is that summer is just about over. But hey, the good news is that we have an entire season of brand new ABC shows to watch and enjoy. And speaking of new shows, I'll be adding my own special twist to the fall primetime schedule here on ABC. My specials will be taking you to all the places that we just can't go. Behind the scenes, behind the cameras, and behind closed doors. So I hope you'll be joining me. Meanwhile, the sun is still hanging around here on Catalina Island. But I get a chance to say something that I never get to say to you guys. Good night, America. This is Joan London.
And Charles Gibson. Tomorrow, which colleges give you the most bang for your tuition bucks?
Also, author Randy Schiltz, singer Daryl Hall, and actor Matthew Modine tomorrow on Good Morning America.
Now stay tuned for Home Improvement, next.